What would have happened if I'd erased that Supra? All right, guys, welcome back to another video. It's your man Jay. So today we're gonna be talking about the Sierra and then also the Camaro. I've had the Sierra now, my new Sierra, for pretty much about a week and a half or so. I'm at about 777 miles. Almost at 1,000 miles, but the difference between this truck and the other truck is no issues with this truck whatsoever. I literally have been having just the best time. I've only been taking this thing on road trips, pretty much driving it at least an hour when I do drive it one way, which is getting me some pretty good fuel economy in comparison to the diesel. Diesel got me great fuel economy. This truck is getting me really good fuel economy. So, but first, the Camaro. This is kind of my, not weekend car, but I only drive this when it's sunny out, and I only drive this when it's pretty much drop top weather. And where I live at, predominantly, it is like that a lot. Now, right now, it's really cool outside, but it's sunny out. And we'll go out and take a look at the truck as well. But the Camaro here, it's been great, man. I mean, I've been driving it more since in the last couple of days. It's been like 80 degrees and nice and warm, breezy. So I've been driving it, and it has just been a blast to drive. Now, as far as the truck goes, well, the truck has been getting a lot of the highway miles. It just so happened here in the last week and a half of having it, or almost 2 weeks of having it, I've just been having to go out of town a lot. And I enjoy it because it's a very comfortable ride. Now, I will say about the seats in the Sierra, they are not as comfortable as the cloth seats that were in the other Sierra that I had. And when I upgraded it to the Catskins seats were so comfortable in addition to that. So the cloth seats have a different padding, and then the Catskins come with additional padding. So I'm really thinking about changing out these leather seats in this one and going with a different color. I've already talked to my guy over there, and he said, for sure I can do it. Obviously, that's what he's gonna say he can do. I love Catskins. I obviously put it in my Camaro as well. These had cloth seats. These seats are extremely comfortable. Oh my God, there's just, the comfort level is off the charts. Because I don't have the Recaro setup in here. It had the regular cloth seats, and then I switched it out to Catskins, which gives it extra padding. And it's just been really good. So I'm really considering adding a different color and a different setup to that truck. I am really considering it, man. And we'll just have to see when that hits, because I am really considering it. So, but the truck has been great, man. We'll go out there and check it out. But you know, nothing fancy with it. It's been doing great. It's just really windy out there, so I didn't want to go out in the wind, but obviously this is my baby right here. Who wouldn't love to drive something like this every day? And the fuel economy on this, when I take it on the highway, when I take it on a long trip, which I haven't done, I've only done that twice. I didn't buy this to like really take it out on long trips. But when I do take it out, the fuel economy is between 20 and 23 or so. For the shortest trip that I'm doing. It's like an hour trip, and it's a lot of uphill, but I drive in sport mode. But when I'm on the highway, I do put it in touring mode sometimes. Overall, this car stays in sport mode. It literally stays in sport mode. Because I love the exhaust sound. I love the exhaust note. I'm really not into, I didn't buy this car to hear it toned down, you know what I mean? So let's go outside and take a look at the truck. See how sunny it is out there? It is super windy out here, man. It is really windy. And so I just got in the passenger side because it's like really windy out here. But I'm pretty excited to finally get this truck on the road, man. I've been driving this truck now, like I said, for about a week and a half. and it has been phenomenal. There have been a few things that I've changed on it. I bought, I hardwired my radio, my radar detector and camera system. I'll show you that. I made a video on this, but you know, I'll show you that in another video. And I've also added the GMC valve caps and things like that for the valve stems. Just little small things like that. But overall, this is a comfortable ride. Now, what I am doing right now is I am looking at rims and tires. And the setup here, and again, real quick, the seats in here, they are just, they're harder and stiffer than the other cloth seats. I mean, and it doesn't look jet black. It looks gray to me. I mean, I don't know. Some of you guys say, hey, Jay, yeah, that is jet black. I guess it's about how your eyes register the color, because it definitely does not look jet black to me. This, like the things like this look jet black, and well, the radio bezels, that's all jet black, and, you know, things like that. I mean, this area, this entire shiny area right here, that's all jet black, but not these seats. And so, you know, and another thing that GM does, they give this light gray, like, two-tone. See how that splits right there? It's dark down here, and then it goes to this light gray, and then it's a light gray on the top. I don't know why they chose to do this, but I really want to get it all color matched. That would be actually pretty sweet. So it's just a matter of preference when it comes down to that. But I am really and this is the exact way the Duramax was as well, but I just changed out the seats, and so it didn't really, it kind of came across differently. The seats popped so much that it just wasn't, I didn't even notice that anymore. So I am really considering changing out these seats quickly, and I am really thinking about doing it. But, you know, driving this truck, if I can touch on that for a little bit, the truck, obviously, for the first 500 miles on my Duramax, it gave me problems. Now, I will say, before I got rid of the Duramax, I'm going to go ahead and say it. I genuinely was thinking about keeping it. I was thinking about keeping the Duramax. I thought about it, man, because that fuel economy is unmatched. That fuel economy is unmatched, and I thought about it. And then after ordering this one, I'd be lying to you if I said, man, I really wanted to try that new Duramax. And he gave me the option. Obviously, I'm buying it, so, you know, obviously I can buy what I want. But, you know, just having the ability to know that I'm going to get a discount on whatever I purchase, a big discount at that. And I will talk about price as well. But just being able to get a huge discount on my new truck, no matter what I buy as compensation, is cool. And but anyway, you know, the Duramax spoiled me when it came to that fuel economy. So I want to touch on fuel economy real quick before I talk anymore. I put out another video talking about the fuel economy on this and how my best times were 25.5. Listen, guys, I think some of you guys love drama. I'm just, it seems like a lot of people commenting like that were just passing by. I don't know if they watched all the other videos, but I'm definitely not one for drama. I'm too old to go back and forth with people. And if you want to feel like you're right, you're right. I am not new to EPAs, okay? So I know what the EPAs are on this truck, and the EPA for highway is not 25 at the best. So in that other video when I posted, some people really got upset, like, oh, you're never going to get that in your dreams and all that kind of stuff. I don't think I've ever said in any of those videos that I'm going to average 25 miles to the gallon around town. In fact, I tell you exactly in those videos that I'm only getting 17 to 20 around town, which to me is still actually really good when you think about this 5.3 liter V8. That's actually phenomenal gas mileage. So I'm averaging basically 19 miles in town for the trips that I'm doing, which are only between 20 and 30 minutes when I'm out and about driving around. So there's the last video I did on the fuel economy. Man, some of you guys got bent out of shape. And I know it's not everybody. It's just those people, though, that feel like they just have to be right, I guess. I don't know. But I'm not averaging 25 miles to the gallon. And some people said, you'll never get that. You'll never get that. Well, already I've already beat the estimated EPA with the trip, a short trip of an hour and a half, by getting 25.5 miles to the gallon. This truck is not rated at 25 miles to the gallon on the highway. Last I checked, I think it was like 22. I'll have to look at my paperwork, but I think it's 22. And I got 25 already for my best time. So what I was saying in that video was, when I take a longer trip, which I have some long trips coming up, I will be able to get a best time of 28 more than likely. I've also given examples on my video with my Durango back in the day. My Durango RT was 390 foot-pounds of torque and what, I forgot what the horsepower is, 380 or 375, I don't know what it is. But that truck was not rated at 29 to 32 miles to gallon on the highway. And I was easily getting 650 to the tank. And that is how I achieve that, by taking a longer trip, obviously. And it depends on elevation, a ton of things that go into you getting fuel economy. So for some reason, the experts come out all of a sudden. I just think people love drama, and they were saying, you're never going to get that, you're never going to get that. I thought it was pretty funny, man. I just told them, let it go, man. I definitely can get a best time, a best fuel economy of 28 on the highway with this truck. It doesn't matter what the EPA is. How did I get the 25 best time if it's not rated at that? I wasn't driving on a light throttle. I was driving the speed limit, which was 70 to 75 miles per hour. So when it comes to fuel economy, we definitely can get better than the EPA. It just depends on that particular trip. So guys, you really got to let that go. I don't think I've ever said that my best time, my average was 25 miles to the gallon. I clearly say, and I think people are just, it just takes for one person to comment in some kind of negative or derogatory way. And then the bottom feeders come along and, you know, the people that are just love drama, they start feeding on that. So it is what it is. You saw my best time on the truck, which is 25.5. I said in the other video, I know I'll get a best time of 28 once I take some of these other trips. And boy, you guys, some of you guys, just a few of you guys ran really honed in on that. I don't think you even watched the video, because I clearly stated what my average miles per gallon were, which is 17 to 20, which to me is still great with this. The Duramax, I was averaging 25 around town. That's fantastic. I know I probably won't get that with this truck around town. I'd have to be on a road that's 30 miles an hour and a long stretch for quite a little bit of time to get that. So nonetheless, I'm totally happy with this truck, because not paying at the pump, gas prices right now on average at the low for diesel are $4 a gallon. Right now I'm paying like $2.50 a gallon for fuel here. It even dropped down to like $2.27, $2.17. That's phenomenal. I don't want to pay at the pump anymore. It's my choice. You don't have to try to convince me. Some people are trying to convince me, oh, you should have got a diesel. What you should do is spend your money how you want to spend it. Everybody's situation is different, and everybody's going to handle their situations differently. I'm choosing to step away from the diesel at this moment because of my first experience with the diesel was not good. And I don't trust that if I keep sticking with the diesel, I won't have all those exhaust problems and all those different emissions to pass. And all this. I don't want to deal with any of that. Regular fuel, and I talked about all in those other videos, I'm totally happy switching back to a V8. I've always driven a V8, and I'm fine with it. Now, this truck as a whole, I have not had one problem. One problem. Now, I think it was one time I tried to do a remote start or something like that, and it didn't remote start, and I had to physically start it. It was too cold outside, I think. Big deal. That happens to a lot of people when you have a remote start on a vehicle. If it's too cold, sometimes it happens. It even happened with the Camaro. The Camaro wouldn't remote start. It was too cold. That's not a problem. But nonetheless, folks, this truck is absolutely phenomenal. So far with the 777 miles, I'm going to give you 1,000 mile, 5,000 mile more than likely, or 2,500 or whatever. Because the miles are racking up quick. That's 777 miles. I actually got that within a matter of 3 or 4 days. And I haven't really driven the truck a lot since then. I've been driving my Camaro. But I got those miles in the first few days of having the truck. And I've had it now for a week and a half. Because I've just been taking this truck out of town immediately. We've been taking it out of town doing longer trips. So regardless of how you think I should purchase a diesel again, or I shouldn't have bought a VA, whatever, it's just your opinion. I respect it, even if I don't agree with it. It doesn't matter. That's where you got to be when you're doing stuff like this. But let's get back in here, because it's very windy and cold. Whew. Garage is really loud. Owning that truck has been great in comparison to my first experience with a diesel, which is in my same truck, 22 Duramax. I've gone over it 1,000 times, man. I love the Duramax performance for the torque up top, and I love the Duramax for the fuel economy. I don't know. I'm totally happy with this V8, man. I love being able to hop in there, and if I need $5 in gas, it can get me a lot compared to the diesel. $5 in gas did nothing. Now, I'm not saying I'm going around putting $5 in gas in there, but if I was in an emergency situation and the prices were what they are now, that $5 in this truck can get me a long way compared to that diesel before having to fill up again. Because I've actually tried that before. In my diesel, I put like $10 in gas. It didn't do anything. $10 in this truck, while I haven't done that yet, I'm sure if I put $10 in this truck with the gas prices, it'll give me what I need to get me where I'm going, cross town, back across town, all the way around with no problem. So the truck, the car, everything is going right now, or it's going as it should go, which is no maintenance issues whatsoever. No maintenance issues on the truck, which is what I'm extremely excited about. I don't want to have any maintenance issues, but I want to talk about price and stuff, and I'll do that in another video or whatever, but I'm pretty happy right now with that truck. I will more than likely, like I said, change out the interior. I know it comes with leather, but that leather, okay, so if you want the HD Vision surround camera system, it's in that package with leather. I wanted the Bose system and I wanted the camera system, and they price it high like that, and you got to get that leather with it. So it's fine. It's just seats. I know plenty of people that rip their leather seats out and put different leather seats in for the color of their choice, but that is probably what I'm going to do. So anyway, it's your man Jay, man. I'm going to get out of here. The truck is doing great, man. I'm totally loving it, and I'm happy that I can put some miles on the Camaro. The Camaro actually has like 1,200 or 1,500 miles or something like that. Still waiting for that break-in period. I've been hammering down on it a little bit. Quick story, I was at a light or something like that the other day. It was like 80 degrees. I got the top up, but I'm still just, it's warm out. And I didn't let the top down until I got into my destination. But there was a guy in like Toyota Supra, one of the new Supras. I can tell he has some modifications, but you know, we just happen to keep coming to a light together, and I'm not trying to race, but the exhaust on this thing is loud, so I'm taking off, getting up to speed, and he's kind of creeping around. And then as soon as this is funny, as soon as we get to a spot where he's kind of in the left lane and I'm kind of blocked off, he punches it. I could see him kind of looking like, oh, I was like, oh, I guess, man. I know those Supras with a tune can easily get to 500 horsepower, and they are fast. But in the end, I still would have ran them if we would have lined up side by side. It doesn't matter if this car weighs more or whatever. Actually, I think they weigh about the same. What would have happened if I'd have raced that Supra? I don't know if he had modifications. It looked good. But what would have happened if I would have raced that Supra? What would have happened? Would he have just walked me, or would I have gotten him on the top end, or what would have happened? Because I don't street race, but there are some street races out there. So, it's your man Jay. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.